This is ABC 7 News at Noon. Your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
Good afternoon and welcome. Thank you for joining us. I'm Don Brennan. Scott Dennis has the day off. Now, topping our news at noon, police are scouring the scene of a French resort town, trying to piece together just who was behind this terrifying attack. People were gathered to celebrate a national holiday when a semi-truck plowed through the crowd, killing 84 people and injuring over 200 people. Now, ABC's Jennifer Eccleston has the latest from London.
Police are scouring the scene in downtown Nice, piecing together just who was behind this terrifying attack as the president of France declares 3 days of mourning. Chaos, screams of panic, and people fleeing for their lives. Celebrations for Bastille Day ending in horror.
You see blood and bodies everywhere.
The truck turning into a lethal weapon, deliberately crashing through groups of people after a fireworks display.
This giant white van was just taking out people left, right, and center.
Within split seconds of hearing the gunshots, I started running, and the entire place seemed like a complete chaos.
Killing dozens, including children. Among the victims, American tourists from Texas, a family member tweeting the terrible news. The driver plowing through crowds for over a mile, stopping only when shot by police.
In the truck itself, we found one automatic pistol, a second automatic fake pistol, two replica assault rifles, one grenade, a mobile phone that we are currently investigating.
Investigators believe the attacker is a 31-year-old man from Tunisia, living in Nice and with a criminal record. France's President François Hollande says it is an act of terror.
This was a direct attack against France, and that is why this individual committed this act.
And the hunt is now on for any accomplices.
French authorities say security cameras in the city are helping to create a timeline of the assault, and hundreds of cameras captured the attacker getting into the truck and later entering the promenade. In London, Jennifer Eccleston, ABC News, now back to you.
Thank you. Now, as mentioned, two of those victims were American. One of those victims was just 11 years old. Brody Copeland of Texas was killed along with his father, Sean. Brody was an aspiring baseball player, and his team posted their condolences on their Facebook page along with this picture from his vacation, another vacation. Now, his whole family was on vacation in the south of France, so they attended the Bastille Day festivities when the tragedy happened. A GoFundMe account has been started for their family. His dad, Sean, was just 51. Back here on the Suncoast, we're hearing reaction from those who have loved ones back in France. ABC 7's Rebecca Vargas joins us now with more on how a Sarasota bistro owner from France is handling this devastation. Rebecca?
Well, Don, yet another attack on the Sarasota man's home country had him concerned for his best friend living in Nice and his daughter flying in from Paris this morning. The owner of C'est la Vie French Bistro in downtown Sarasota is from Paris. His best friend lives in Nice, and Christophe Cattell was able to get a hold of his friend late last night and was relieved that he is, in fact, safe, but was told the fear in the city is strong. While he doesn't understand the target on his own home country, his family is not letting fear take away their freedom.
Talking with my friends and family and everything, nobody wants really to live in that fear. They want to live. They want to live without thinking about this.
Cattell says with Bastille Day being a day the French people celebrate their freedom, as we Americans do on the 4th of July, the promenade was an easy target. Don, back to you.
Thank you, Rebecca. In light of the tragedy in France, Donald Trump is putting a hold on officially announcing his running mate for vice president, kind of officially, at least publicly. He is tweeting about it, though. This morning, Trump tweeted Indiana Governor Mike Pence as his choice for vice president. Pence reportedly has accepted the job. He plans on holding a press conference about this tomorrow. The presumptive Republican nominee canceled a news conference today where he planned to announce Pence as his choice because of the tragedies. Now, in a convoluted way, stolen firearms in Sarasota led to the abrupt cancellation of a town hall meeting in the wake of police shootings throughout the country. Sarasota police arrested 39-year-old Joseph Stout. According to the Sarasota police, Stout is a convicted felon. On Wednesday, police say he broke into a home and stole an AR-7 rifle and 700 rounds of ammunition along with a pack of cigarettes. He then attempted to sell the rifle and ammunition at a pawn shop. The incident was the reason why Chief Bernadette Tupino abruptly postponed the meeting with the NAACP, and that meeting has now been rescheduled for July 25th. Stout, he's being charged with possession of a firearm and ammunition by a convicted felon and defrauding a pawnbroker. He's being held at the Sarasota County Jail on $125,000 bond. In Manatee County, a popular and successful private defense attorney was found dead in his home. The body of Mark Lipinski was found by a co-worker Thursday morning. Now, that co-worker had gone to check on him when he failed to show up in court, which is very unlike him. He's been known to work 15, 18-hour days regularly. Deputies with the Manatee County Sheriff's Office were called to the scene to investigate. Although he seemed fine to friends on Wednesday and no health issues, the death is not suspicious at this point. Lipinski has been practicing law in Bradenton since 1990, and his cases will continue to be handled by his office. A public memorial service is being planned, but no details as of yet have been revealed. Lipinski was 65 years old. Construction on Siesta Key's second daiquiri deck is underway. The restaurant will occupy the top floor of the new three-story building at Stickney Point Road. The outdoor deck will offer views of Siesta Key Beach and the Gulf of Mexico, and the restaurant could be serving on the south end of the island as soon as next spring. The local chain currently has three restaurants, one in St. Armand's, one in Venice, and the original Siesta Key Village. Now, Daiquiri Deck is best known for its bar, which is backed by a line of Slurpee-like beverage machines that serve daiquiris and a variety of salads and seafood. Now, Uber is celebrating National Ice Cream Day a little early. The company is partnering with frozen dessert maker Magnum to deliver ice cream bars in more than 400 cities in 69 countries, including right here in Sarasota. Anyone with the Uber app can have two ice cream bars free delivered to them within minutes. All you have to do is open the Uber app, put in your location, and click the ice cream option. And the free ice cream is being handed out between 11 and 3, which is right now it's in its heyday, right in the middle, which means you still have time to get some. John and I might order some right now. This is the fifth year that Uber is offering the ice cream delivery. National Ice Cream Day is actually on Sunday, John.
We should do this.
But with all this heat, the ice cream melt rather quickly. You gotta eat it quick.
I would think that they have to be outfitted with some kind of special equipment. Don't you think?
I think we should app them and see if they can drive by and give us a look-see.
Let's do it. Break out the cell phones and let's get some Jerry Garcia in here.
There you go.
Or whatever we can get.
Cherry Garcia.
I'll take whatever I can get. I am not particular. You know me. We have some pretty decent weather out there right now. They may have to dodge a few thunderstorms a little bit later in the afternoon, but currently it's beautiful out there. A lot of blue sky, some fair weather clouds building. Ooh, did you see that crepuscular ray there for just a moment? That was a very nice shot. Some showers and thunderstorms out in Gulf waters. They've been kind of persistent out there during these morning hours. They're a good distance offshore, 60, 100 miles offshore. But otherwise, they're not coming to land. We do have some showers trying to make their way over from the other coast. We'll be talking about that in detail in a few minutes. For today, I think we can lower the distribution of rainfall just a little bit. We'll go with about a 40% coverage during the evening hours. And the showers will probably start later in the day. But daytime highs will remain warm, coming in around 93 degrees or so. We'll have that complete forecast for the weekend coming up in just a minute, Don.
Thank you, John. Taxes are going up in Venice. Yes, the city council is approving the city's first tax increase in 3 years. The new rate will increase property taxes by 50 cents per every $1,000 of assessed property value. With the increase, the city will collect $12 million in property taxes. This year, it collected $9.5 million. Two public hearings will be held at City Hall in September to discuss these tax changes. Well, speaking of money, ABC 7 business commentator Jeff Stern is joining us now. Jeff, thanks for joining us. And, well, with this five-day rally, what should we know about?
You're correct, Don. 5 days in a row we've been up. We like that. The Dow's leading the way, 3.4% from this rally. NASDAQ as well as the S&P are there as well. What shall we know? Well, first of all, the new highs for the Dow and the S&P yesterday. We'll see if we can hit another new high today. China had some good news, 6.7% economic growth, a little bit above what the economists were thinking, but it's not what they used to do, but they're still growing, which is positive. And that 10-year treasury is still about 1.5%. Well, as you know, I wake up this morning and then actually the futures were down just a little bit. As I was making my kale shake earlier, or a little bit later, I should say, they were up. So let's see how we are currently trading. The Dow Jones Industrial Average is trading at 18,506, up, get this, 0.08%, and that's no change. NASDAQ 5,028, down 5 points. That's a 0.1%. While the S&P is trading at 2,160, down 2.87. That's 0.13%.
All right. No questions. We'll, go into the numbers. What's up with that?
Definitely. We'll take a look and see what the two of the biggest overachievers are doing. We'll look at Warren Buffett. He gave away $2.9 billion, most of that going to the Gates Fund, 2.2 to their foundation. Don't worry, that's only about 5% of his worth. This is the 11th year he's been doing it. He started this with the Gates Foundation, and they said, let's start the giving pledge and encourage people to give away their assets. You must be a billionaire to begin with, but that's the whole deal. So far, there's 154. The other big headlines, Mark Zuckerberg, he pledged, overachiever, to run 365 miles this year. You know what? He already completed it. He says he loves it, and he really is pretty fast, actually, at a 5.53-minute mile. As well as he's ready for triathlon now. He thinks that's going to be a little bit harder, but he's ready for the challenge. And yes, he has pledged to donate and give away 99% of Facebook in his lifetime. So, Don, there's a lot of good people out there making a lot of good money, helping people work with jobs, but they're also giving back. So positive for all that.
Well, that's good to hear. Really, a kale shake? I know you're a triathlete as well. Is that why you're drinking kale shakes, John?
So you got that, Don.
All right, thanks for joining us. We'll see you again soon. Now let's check in with ABC 7 Culinary Director Judy Gallagher, who's joining us today from Danny's Pizzeria in Bradenton.
Welcome to Danny's Pizzeria in Bradenton. We are so excited to be here, and thanks to the community and our intern Chloe, who got us hooked up with this place. We love it. These people are from New York. You're going to get real authentic New York pizza, but so much more. I mean, this is the real deal restaurant, whether it's mussels and homemade garlic knots and calzone to pastas and chickens and so much more. We are about to take a trip to New York right here in Bradenton on State Road 64, and it is going to be delicious. So stay with me throughout the hour. You're going to get to meet Danny and Danny Jr., and you're going to get to meet Dave, the general manager, and between everybody, you're going to see why we pick this as a great place to come for lunch, besides all the food.
Need new windows? Buy direct from the factory. New South Window is having a sale. The more you buy, the more you save. Buy four windows, save 25%. Buy six windows, save 30%. Buy eight or more windows and save 35%. How? Because New South owns the factory and you cut out the middleman. Award-winning, energy-efficient windows and doors installed with a lifetime warranty. New South Windows are made in Florida for Florida homes by Florida workers. Visit newsouthwindow.com or call now.
Is your mop a dirty, disgusting mess? You need the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System, the only mop and bucket that spins the dirt away. A system that cleans practically anything and everything with super absorbent microfiber. Dip it in the washer side and the mess releases into the bucket. Then place it in the dryer side and push on the pedal. You get a clean mop head that's practically dry and ready for more. And your hands will never again touch a dirty, disgusting mop. The heads are washable and reusable. Get the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System for just two payments of $19.99. You'll also get a Sticky Buddy, the reusable sticky roller that picks up pet hair and lint and washes clean in seconds. You can take advantage of our 2-for-1 pick it up special and get a second spin mop set. Just pay additional shipping and fee. And we'll upgrade you to free priority handling. So don't wait. Order now.
Call 1-800-394-1524 to get your Hurricane Spin Mop double offer. So hurry and call 1-800-394-1524. Call now.
Today, everyone is looking for more fashionable choices in flooring than ever before. And G. Fried has responded with a huge selection of carpets, tile, wood, laminate, and vinyl. Installed by a highly skilled team, G. Fried has got everything you're looking for and more. the next time you think about quality flooring, think G. Fried Flooring America. G. Fried Flooring America. Our world is at your feet.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free. AndServices.com. AndServices.com.
It's time again for My Suncoast's Bark in the Park with the Bradenton Marauders at McKechnie Field. Bring your best friend and let them run the bases in support of the Humane Society of Manatee County, July 24th at 1 p.m. Visit BradentonMarauders.com for info. Sponsored by ABC7. Now, the official Suncoast weather with ABC7 meteorologist John Scalzi.
Currently outside, we're on our way to another hot day with 90 degrees already. 72 degree dew point with a southwest wind coming in at about 5. A mix of sun and clouds out there. And we have building showers down to our south, gradually drifting up in this direction, bringing us again today chances of showers and thunderstorms. But there are differences as well as the similarities between today's forecast and yesterday's forecast. 88 degrees in Wachula, Parrish, Bradenton, Lakewood Ranch, 87 degrees. In Northport, Punta Gorda comes in at 89. 88 degrees in Venice, 86 degrees in Inglewood, 88 in Arcadia. We're looking at Mayaca City at 88 and Lamboki at 85. So across the region, we had the one round of showers that moved out into Gulf waters, kind of persistently staying out there. We are not going to see any of that really return, though some of the stuff down to the south could start to curve back in toward the coastline as we develop more of a westerly wind flow this afternoon with the sea breeze. We have some showers down to the south. We have a lot of showers actually down to the south of us. But over the north central part of the coastline, north central and all the way down to about Lauderdale, we have less than we had yesterday in terms of coverage at this time of day. And the reason for that is some drier air has moved in. Around Lake Okeechobee, we got a few showers ongoing, but clearly the frontal boundary, as it were, the East Coast sea breeze front, is starting to make its trek across the state, just as it has over the last couple of days. And that will encourage the formation of showers and thunderstorms again this afternoon. But there's fewer storms around. And locally, there's nothing going on right now, though before the end of this broadcast, there could be a shower or two building. The reason that we have fewer showers around is this drier air indicated here by the tan contours that's kind of moved in across central Florida. There's more of it out here, too, in the Atlantic waters. And in fact, even more than that further out. This is Saharan dust. It's beginning to build. It's on its way toward us, and it will be moving into the Caribbean as we head into next work week. In fact, here is a NASA forecast that this graphic created by our own Steve Newman. And it shows a 10-day forecast of what's going to happen with this Sahara dust. And you can see that it is trekking at a pretty good speed across the entire Atlantic basin. And it will influence our weather from time to time over the week ahead. That's number one. Number two, this high-pressure ridge is more in line with central Florida currently. And that is impacting our weather forecast perhaps a little more directly than it did yesterday. Yesterday, it certainly did influence the direction of our winds. Today, it also influences the stability of our atmosphere aloft so that we will get a few less showers around today and tomorrow as well, in combination with that drier air. By Sunday, I think it has retreated back out into the Atlantic. We still get this southeasterly wind flow. We still get the collision of east and west coast sea breezes, and we'll still have excellent rain chances on Sunday. But for 2 days, we'll cut down the number of storms that we get just a little bit. So the forecast calls for afternoon thunderstorms, some gusty storms possible, that's still certainly possible, and partly sunny skies with heat indexes once again around 108. That's not going to change. So look for that southwest wind at about 10 knots becoming west in the afternoon with that sea breeze. And the forecast right straight through the next 7 days shows kind of up and down rain chances. Next couple of days, less rain. Then we get back to that kind of typical summertime pattern, maybe even a little enhanced summertime pattern. And then by midweek next week, we'll start to trim down those rain chances a little bit again. Don?
Thank you, John. And health news, if you plan on doing some baking this weekend, you're going to be dealing with flour. You may want to watch out because you can get E. coli from flour, apparently. Uncooked flour can give you an E. coli infection. So think twice about foods like truffles, icing, or even baking cookies. These recipes don't involve heating or baking, then that could also lead to E. coli. And be wary of where you're storing your flour. If you dump new flour into a container with old flour in it, you could be running the risk of getting sick. And watch out for your kids. Recipes for modeling clays, Play-Dohs, and ornaments use flour as the main ingredient, and children are likely to put those items in their mouth. As parents, we're all too familiar about those frightened cries and fearful snuggles after our child has had a nightmare, and there's a number of reasons why they may have them. According to doctors, one reason can be their daily activities. Also, your child's sleeping environment and routine can play a role. You want to make sure their rooms are happy and fun and keep them from watching scary movies or TV shows before bedtime or on their phones or on their computers. Doctors say it can be difficult for kids to separate a nightmare from reality, which can make it difficult for them to go back to sleep.
Oftentimes, nightmares come in periods of either increased fatigue or increased stress. And that could be a busy school day, you know, losing a soccer game, an uncomfortable encounter with a stranger or even a familiar person.
Creating a dream catcher to hang above their bed is also a good idea. Also, talking them through their nightmare and reassuring them that they are safe will help. If nightmares persist or become worse, it's a good idea to talk to your child's pediatrician or a mental health professional. Up next, we have a little four-legged friend in the studio who needs a home. God bless you, John. We'll tell you about our pet of the week coming up, and later we'll tell you how you can catch them all this weekend at Busch Gardens.
ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names. Really? They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
Call right now to get your free Senior Care Compass ebook. Find out about the 5 best kept secrets on financing senior care and assisted living.
Call now, 800-290-0352. 800-290-0352.
Is your old garage door stuck or broken? Would a new one give you a lift? Let Precision Door Overhead Garage Door Service of Sarasota come to the rescue with prompt and affordable repair service. Replacement doors come with an array of styles and colors, and they are rated to meet and exceed Florida standards. From estimates to installation, your satisfaction is our priority. If you're not 100% satisfied with any product, service, or installation, we will make it right, because Precision Door Service is a name you can trust.
They care. They take the time to understand you, take the time to understand your case.
There's no better satisfaction to me than to see a client who is happy because of the job we've done for them.
It's really actually very comforting to know that there's someone that you've heard of and you're getting recommendations about that you can turn to when you have a problem.
I felt like I had a partner in this, and he was going to be by my side.
They're coming from Tampa, Fort Myers, even Orlando. They're coming from everywhere for the Sarasota Ford Promise. We promise we're more than a dealership. We're a destination with a movie theater, massage room, aquarium, cafe, and more. We promise to give you top dollar for your trade, even if you don't buy from us. And if you do, we promise you the best deal. Bring us any competitor's ad, and we'll beat it by at least $1,000. That's why they're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, where 41 meets 301. SarasotaFord.com.
Welcome back, everybody. We have another pet to share with you today. His name is Rookie, and I'm not talking about John Scalzi, that's for sure. He's looking to make his home yours. So John joins us now, the founder of Dante's Den and host of Animal Outtakes, Marsha Panucci, with today's Pet of the Week.
What an adorable dog, Marcia. Oh, my gosh. Rookie, huh?
Rookie.
What beautiful eyes Rookie has. My goodness. Now, oh, where are you going
if
to?
You look at Rookie, Rookie has the most gorgeous eyes because one is blue and one is brown. Rookie is about 2 years old, and we're all kind of trying to see what we see. Is he a little bit Jack Russell? Is he a little bit Chihuahua? We think he's just plain adorable, John.
Sweet.
He's a sweet boy.
Dog. Kind of a little freaked by the cameras, as is wont to happen with this place.
He's 2 years old, and he loves to play, and he loves to run around. He loves, absolutely loves to ride in cars. So he's going to be a great companion for you that way. And one of the high points is, as you know, John, we always have to clip their nails, and it's something that we don't like to do. This guy likes a manicure, pedicure on a regular basis and doesn't fight you for it.
No, really doesn't.
Yeah, isn't he adorable?
Really sweet. Now, how many pounds? Probably about 12 pounds, 14 pounds?
I'm going to say somewhere around 12 to... plus pounds, not too much.
And do we know, I mean, Chihuahua mix, I guess, right?
Yeah, so. I'm going to say Chihuahua mix. I see a little, as I said, Jack Russell in him, but how can you not love this pup? And he loves everybody that he comes in contact with. However, however is he would love to be with adults and not children.
I get
so
it.
We need
so what
to
are you hanging
him.
Around me for? I don't understand that at all.
But he is just absolutely wonderful. And, of course, he's brought to us today by the Bishop's Animal Shelter, which is out in Bradenton.
Yes, we adopted a dog from them. Great place.
Oh, they're
a
wonderful
very friendly,
group.
All really nice.
Yeah.
It's a very easy process to adopt a dog, so they don't make it hard. I know, right, Don? Yeah. Is this not the most cute dog in the world? Oh, he could just eat you up. Look at you.
Would you like to do the newscast
eyes.
With him, Don?
Oh, my goodness. Look at those
eyes.
It's
like
eyes.
He wants to be somewhere else.
Yeah, he just loves to be loved.
Now, hold you say 2 years, you
He's
think?
He's 2 years old, and you have to remember something. When they come here into the studio, there's bright lights, and there's the cameras. The robotic
cameras
are scaring him.
Yeah.
But look at he's in
you
your lap, and now he's
you can hide. It's all right. Bishop Animal Shelter. There's the number on your screen, 792-2863. Give him a call and adopt this beautiful animal.
Rookie
Marcia,
will be waiting.
Thanks so much. Bye, Rookie. Say goodbye to Donnie. John, your turn. Bye.
Oh, man, he's adorable.
You are adorable.
I think I'm going to take him. Now, we go from Rookie to Foodies with Chef Judy. She's enjoying lunch at Danny's Pizzeria.
The man behind the name and all this great food is Dan from New York. Thanks so much for having us here at Danny's Pizzeria.
Well, thanks for having me. Tell us
your history, Dan.
Basically, I've been in the business since I was 14, and I've been doing this my whole life. And I moved here to Florida and opened this place about 6 years ago. And it is just an amazing place. I love it down here. And the people are great, and I'm just very happy to be here.
Well, I can tell not only are you happy to be here, but your servers, your cooks, and mostly your customers are so happy to be here. This feels like New York. What do you think your background in opening in Bradenton has brought that New York feel from the decor to right down to the good old food?
Well, I base everything on a family business where we all started. My wife and my kids all work for me. And my chef and his family work for me, and their families worked in the business. And my, you know, it's just one of those very excellent family atmospheres. And I've always said, we have great food here. I'm proud of what we serve, but it's my employees that make our business. And, you know, they're such good kids. And so
you're lighting up as you're talking about this, and that really touches our heart. And I think that's what really relates to hospitality. And Dan, you clearly have the hospitality down. And I know we're going to talk to the manager in a few minutes about all this great food. What do you mostly want people to know as they're pulling in into the parking lot and coming in? What do you want them to know about Danny's?
Basically that give us a try. If you haven't been here yet, the food is great. It's very fresh. We make everything we possibly can here. And the atmosphere is great. It's very casual. you know, family oriented. You could be loud, whatever you want,
And beer, wine, and sangria, right?
That's right. We have, you know, all a big selection of beers. We have 9 taps, a bunch of bottles, and a few other things like the sangria and stuff.
And they're ready for you, and we're ready to come back and find out about this great cuisine in a few minutes.
Florida Studio Theater presents the 8th Annual Sarasota Improv Festival, July 14th through 16th. 3 days of non-stop comedy with 18 groups from New York City, Atlanta, Austin, Boston, Chicago, Columbia, Canada, Orlando, and more. The laughter will be unlimited. Don't miss what Daily City says is non-stop lunacy. Featured acts will include premier improv group Impro Theater. Improv Festival passes and tickets are on sale now. 941-366-9000 or visit floridastudiotheater.org.
Since 1928, Karastan has been setting the standard in carpets and rugs, producing non-allergenic wools that won't promote the growth of bacteria or dust mites like other carpets will. Karastan wools actively remove contaminants from the indoor air, making your home healthier. And there are many colors and patterns and textures to choose from. Come see for yourself.
So many possibilities worth exploring. Minnesota Flooring.
This is a special health alert for seniors suffering with joint pain. If you have Medicare insurance, you may qualify for high-quality support braces at little or no cost.
I'm thrilled with my knee braces.
Now, there is a simple and proven solution for seniors to get out of pain with state-of-the-art support braces.
I barely feel any pain at all.
Braces for your knees and back, as well as your shoulders and ankles, too.
I'm so happy with the quality of these braces.
Call now, and you could qualify for a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost.
I can play ball again, and it doesn't hurt.
And because of my Medicare coverage, it costs me next to nothing.
So call now.
And because I have this red, white, and blue Medicare card, my braces have cost me just about nothing.
It's true. You may get a knee, back, shoulder, and ankle brace at little or no cost.
They qualified me for 2 knee braces and a back brace.
If you have knee or back pain, give them a call. They can help.
1-800-476-8967. 1-800-476-8967.
Dog days of summer got you down? Beat the heat with huge summer savings during the summer clearance event going on now at Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota. You'll feel cooler than ever when you drive away in a new Jeep Cherokee for as little as $19,999. Or take home a stylish new Jeep Renegade for just $18,599. How about a new 2016 Jeep Patriot for just $14,999? Better prices, bigger selection. Go to Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. For a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today. Sleep on it tonight.
Live from our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is ABC 7 News at Noon. Your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
Welcome back, everybody. I'm Don Brennan, in for Scott Dennis. Now, in the race for the White House, Donald Trump's choice for a running mate may come in the form of a tweet after postponing the event in the wake of the attack in France. Now, the move comes just days away from the Republican National Convention. Donald Trump's made it official, tweeting, "I am pleased to announce that I have chosen Governor Mike Pence as my vice presidential running mate." Pence landed in New York City overnight as Trump took to Fox News.
Mike has done a great job as governor of Indiana. You look at the numbers and it's been a great, you know, he's done really a fantastic job.
Trump canceled his big news conference citing the attack in France.
Out of respect for this horrific situation, I just think it was inappropriate to have the news conference tomorrow.
Meanwhile, Hillary Clinton is out auditioning a potential vice president of her own, Senator Tim Kaine from Virginia. Meanwhile, security is already beefed up for the Republican and Democratic conventions.
We have within DHS some 3,000 personnel that will be dedicated to the security of the Republican National Convention and the Democratic National Convention each, consisting of Secret Service, TSA, Homeland Security Investigations, Customs Border Protection, NPPD, Coast Guard.
Department of Homeland Security Secretary Jay Johnson in Cleveland today to see security preps firsthand after warning lawmakers that radical activists could be drawn to the RNC next week.
I am concerned about the prospect of demonstrations getting out of hand.
The Convention Rules Committee has been meeting nonstop, and anti-Trump GOP leaders can make their last attempt Monday to amend delegate rules to try and block Trump from getting the nomination. Of course, a reminder, ABC 7 will be there and have special coverage of both the Republican and the Democratic National Conventions. So Monday we begin as ABC 7's Ray Collins and Alan Cohn will be in Cleveland for the Republican Convention. Then the following week it's the Democratic Convention, and Haley Wilgus and Adam Cellini will join Alan in Philadelphia to bring you all the latest developments. There will be no Trump tweet uncovered. In Louisiana, family and friends gathered this morning to remember the life of Alton Sterling. Sterling was shot and killed while he was pinned to the ground by two police officers outside of a convenience store last week in Baton Rouge. Police say they shot him because he tried to reach for a gun in his pocket. Al Sharpton and Jesse Jackson reportedly attended the services. Alton's death has set off a nationwide protest against police killings, particularly African Americans in the same situations. Raw emotions were reflected last night during President Obama's town hall meeting. Hosted by ABC News, the president spoke about race relations and policing in America. He discussed his own personal experiences as well, and he also defended the phrase Black Lives Matter. He didn't have any solutions, but says at least people are finally talking about this. CNN also held a similar town hall meeting last night, and families of the victims of the recent shootings had a chance to meet, and the relatives are finding common ground in their pain.
Violence to violence is not gonna never be the answer to nothing, especially not in the situation that me and this family is sharing right now. And I think we all come together to say that we want peace.
This has to stop. By taking another person's life, it won't make the other person's life come back.
Mm-mm.
You know, we need to all live together.
Zamaripa's son was one of the Dallas police officers. He had served three tours overseas, and he died on his homeland. Now, Philando Castile was laid to rest yesterday. Funerals for victims will continue throughout the weekend, and the Dallas officer, Patrick Zamaripa, will be laid to rest tomorrow. But here in Florida, several Florida communities are borrowing a slogan from the national movement, Black Lives Matter, to raise awareness about the state's algae crisis. A toxic bloom has been spreading across West Palm Beach's area. Now, the slogan, Our Lives Matter, too, has been circling around to counteract the push from coastal residents and environmentalists to buy agricultural land south of Lake Okeechobee. Now, this land would provide another outlet for water and reduce the need for harmful algae bloom releases that end up in the area. The Willenda clan is back at it, but this time it's not Nick Willenda, it's his wife who's pulling off this ultimate stunt. Erindira Willenda set a world record yesterday in Atlantic City for dangling 150 feet over the Atlantic Ocean from a helicopter. The wife of the Sarasota Wire artist and daredevil performed, and she revolved on an aerial loop at least 35 times, and after the stunt she wasn't too dizzy to dazzle the crowd with a few tricks along the shore before touching down. At the Trump Taj Mahal, the stunt kicks off her husband's variety show, and that will include stunts from Nick himself and other circus performers. And this is Erindira's first world record. Wow, and it looks like it was beautiful weather up there. There's been some, there's been a lot of rain over the last few weeks up there, a little crazy weather up there. There's been some very hot weather here.
Severe weather. I did not know that Nick had a variety show now.
I did not either.
How about that?
Yes, some variety is the spice of life, John.
It's awesome. Yes, indeed. That's great. Good for him.
Yeah.
We've got a little bit of variety in our weather this afternoon. Yesterday we had multiple showers and thunderstorms, some of them really big, and we will have some showers around again today, but the number will be less. Beautiful, beautiful Lakewood Ranch webcam shot of the sunrise and dawn breaking on the Sun Coast, leading to some blue sky out there. Pretty stable air mass to start the day off, but then with a little heating, things kind of heated up a bit, started percolating. We got a few fair weather clouds out there currently. Further out, further away from us, we have some actual showers in progress down around Lake Okeechobee, where the moisture is a little bit thicker. Now, we've had some drier air that's filtered in, and that may reduce our rainfall chances a little bit. Not dramatically, but a little bit. So we'll go with about a 40% chance of showers and thunderstorms this afternoon. Daytime high again tops out warm with a feels-like temperature up around 105. So stay cool, Donnie.
Thank you, John. May have to get some Uber ice cream. Now, today, a Florida court could be making some big decisions about the biggest airbag recall in U.S. history. A court in Jacksonville will be considering whether the family of a Jacksonville woman killed, whose death is linked to the faulty Takata airbags, can ask for punitive damages. The airbags have been recalled from some 69 million cars because they can explode and hurt drivers and passengers alike. They have been linked to several deaths as well right here in the U.S. The judge will also decide whether Takata's CEO would have to testify in court. Federal officials say it will take another 3 years to replace all of the recalled airbags. And Busch Gardens is getting in on the Pokemon Go craze. This weekend, the theme park will host a lure-a-thon. Pokemon Go users will be able to wander the park with their cell phones to collect as many Pokemon as possible. Park admission is required to play the game. The lure-a-thon is this Saturday, tomorrow, from 10 in the morning till 3 in the afternoon. Park Pass members will have exclusive access to 7 Poke stops in the Egypt area of the park, and that'll be from 8:30 in the morning until 9:30. And ABC 7 Culinary Director Judy Gallagher is out at Danny's Pizzeria in Bradenton, and she's checking back in with us from there.
Okay, this is Dave, the general manager, and Dave, you are one happy man
yes.
today because you get to showcase
right.
your cuisine. So
yes.
let's start right here with the
okay.
mussels.
So right here we have the mussels. It's a spicy Diablo sauce, so we either offer that or a white wine garlic sauce, you know, if you want to mix it up.
Yeah.
We do a mushroom soup, homemade soups every day. So different soups.
And I've been having some homemade soup over here in between breaks, and it's delicious.
It is, yes.
A good chef makes a darn good soup.
That is correct.
Let's talk about the rice ball.
Okay, so we have a rice ball, which is our homemade rice balls we do every weekend. It's a great rice mixture, plenty of cheeses, fresh ingredients, just something a lot of people in Florida haven't had before. And it's nice to bring it down from New York to here.
Exactly.
You know?
So. Exactly. Now, I love your twist on the Cuban sandwich.
Yes,
tell us what's in that.
That's correct. I'm not going to tell you all the secrets about
it.
Oh,
darn it.
But we do a homemade, it's kind of a secret dressing. It's a Caesar mustard mixture.
Well, we kind of got part of this secret seasoning.
Yeah. I won't tell you everything else. We got some banana peppers in there. You know, it's
nice.
A little twist on a traditional dish.
A little New York Italian.
That's right. That's right.
I like it. Now, I've got to talk about Big Ziti, one
yes.
of my son's favorites and my personal favorite, too.
Yes, absolutely. And you could see the portion of it.
Yeah.
You could either feed one person or, you know, a small village.
Yeah.
You know, so, you know, it's more than people can ask for when they come in. You know, they're surprised on the sizes and just everything about it. So.
And we have to talk about New York pizza. Now,
yes,
having grown up in Connecticut and the mm-hmm. New York area,
yeah.
I feel like I know New York pizza.
Yeah.
This is New York pizza.
That's right. You know, and, you know, that's our staple is, you know, people read our reviews, see it, you know, and there's no comparison. All you need to try is once. And they're hooked, you know.
Is it really the water that makes a difference?
You know, I'm not going to get into details with that, but that's, you know, it's a portion of it, yes.
Yeah,
but,
and it's real New York pie.
Absolutely. Fresh ingredients, you know, fresh everything. So nothing's frozen.
Now, I know you've been hankering to talk about your calzone.
Yes, yes.
Let's talk about the calzone.
All right,
here.
The calzone, I mean, obviously it's, you know, you see the size of it, and that's just a regular size. We also offer family size, which is enough for quite a few people. But
if you're willing to share.
Yeah, if you're willing to share.
So this is Dave. It's been a great visit. Salads, homemade wings, pasta dishes, and specials every day. Stay with me. It's dessert time next.
ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
Just because someone grows older, does that mean they have to grow apart from their friends or from the things they love to do? With Right at Home, it doesn't. Right at Home's professional team thoughtfully selects caregivers to help with personal care, housekeeping, meals, and most of all, staying engaged in life.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome. Are you ready to go?
Oh, I sure am.
We can provide the right care right at home.
At Sunset Subaru in Sarasota, it's all about getting more for your money. More years, more miles, more 2016 IIHS Top Safety Pick Plus winners than any other brand. Stop by to see our new state-of-the-art showroom today, and you can lease the most award-winning small SUV on the planet, a new 2016 Subaru Forester, for just $229 a month, complimentary maintenance included, at Sunset Subaru in Sarasota. Get more for your money. Go to Sunset Subaru in Sarasota.
Are you or a loved one currently suffering from chronic knee pain, arthritis, or osteoarthritis of the knee? Has physical therapy, surgery, steroid injections, ibuprofen, and other NSAIDs failed to provide relief? Then you may be a candidate for our Advanced Arthritis Relief Protocol. The AARP program utilizes the latest fluoroscopic guidance technology to deliver a new joint fluid supplement that cushions the knee and reduces pain. Specialized knee bracing is then applied to unload the knee and increase joint space. Finally, advanced rehabilitative therapies are performed to strengthen the muscles and ligaments of the knee. When combined, these treatments have helped many patients reduce or even eliminate their joint pain and return to normal active lifestyles. The best part is the AARP program is covered by most insurance, including Medicare. Tired of living with knee pain? Then call the number on your screen right now to see if you qualify for our Advanced Arthritis Relief Protocol.
Showers and thunderstorms in the forecast again this afternoon, just perhaps a few less of them. Temperature currently at 90 degrees with a dew point of 72. High dew points, warm temperatures, heat indexes are up there. About 105, 108 degrees again today, so clearly dehydration continues to be a problem here on the Sun Coast, so make sure you stay hydrated. Mix of sun and clouds out there with building thunderstorm activity around Lake Okeechobee. Temperatures across the peninsula are generally running in the upper 80s to low 90s most everywhere. We've broken the 90-degree mark in a few locations. Daytona coming in at 91, Orlando at 90, West Palm at 90, Naples at 90. In fact, even locally, we have many 90s in the area. 90 degrees at Arcadia Parish, Bradenton, Sarasota. Almost 90 in Punta Gorda with an 89 there, 88 in Northport, and Venice comes in at 88 degrees as well. So we have the southeasterly wind flow. That still has not changed. We have a high-pressure ridge that remains to our north, but it has nosed its way down the peninsula just a little bit and migrated a little further out in Gulf waters, such that that is a suppressive feature to the development of showers and thunderstorms. Oh, we'll still get our sea breeze. We still have plenty of moisture available in the atmosphere. We just don't have an atmosphere that's as happy to produce showers and thunderstorms today. So we'll have a few less of them. Showers, as I mentioned, some pretty good ones, in fact, around Lake Okeechobee currently. There's probably some pretty good gusty winds considering the shape of that radar echo. There's probably some gusty winds in and around that. Headed in our direction, we'll see those outflow boundaries, that sea breeze front, begin to penetrate into our neck of the woods probably around 2-3 o'clock, and a few scattered showers building in inland areas. The onset of showers near the coast might be just a little bit later, but still high pressure will remain a dominant weather feature for us for the next couple of days. We will see showers around because of the moisture that's in the atmosphere, but slightly drier air aloft has also filtered in. So that may also aid in reducing the number of showers that we get. By the end of the weekend, that high moves back out in the Atlantic and we're back to really where we were yesterday, which is a pretty good coverage of showers and thunderstorms. Afternoon storms, some gusty winds, partly sunny skies, helping to boost our heat indexes up to about 105. You can see that kind of drier air indicated by that tan contour. That's one of the limiting factors in shower and thunderstorm development today. Southwest wind, 10 knots, turning west in the evening at 10 knots, 2-foot seas, light chop, and the official Suncoast forecast calls for less rain chance over the next couple of days, then increased rain chance for a couple of days, then we'll dip back down as some Saharan dust approaches us, Don.
Thank you, John. Now, the Southwest Florida Women's Dive Club is holding an underwater beach cleanup this weekend at Siesta Beach. Now, club members say they saw a need after thousands of visitors lined the beach for the 4th of July holiday and then left a line of trash in their wake. The cleanup will be in honor of the worldwide celebration of Women's Dive Day. Female scuba divers from all over the world will be coming to participate, and the cleanup takes place tomorrow. Also happening this weekend, Sarasota County is encouraging its residents to keep their home looking quite spiffy by taking part in a neighborhood cleanup. The Pinecraft, Sarasota Springs, and Southgate neighborhoods all will be having a community cleanup. It's an opportunity for folks to get rid of any household items, yard waste, and other garbage around their homes. And the cleanup takes place tomorrow from 8 to noon. Free dumpsters will be available at several locations, including the Southgate Community Center. And a Rolling Stone is gathering no moss. He doesn't seem to be ready to give up fatherhood either. We'll tell you about that. And who are you going to call? The new Ghostbusters finally in theaters. But are there enough ghouls to go around and knock out the competition? We'll tell you coming up next.
Mom needed more care than we could provide, so we called Granny Nannies. She now has around-the-clock caregivers, and we have peace of mind. Thanks to them, she's where she belongs, at home.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
Hurricane season is here, so when severe weather threatens, count on the official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7.
We bring you storm warnings faster and with more detail than ever before.
And track storms right down to your neighborhood.
On air, online, and on your mobile device, turn to the official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7. We're here for you.
We're losing exotic animals on a daily basis, and the ones that we have in captivity are really the ambassadors for their wild counterparts. I'm Clayton Rosaire from the Big Cat Habitat and Gulf Coast Sanctuary, housing over 150 exotic animals that needed a great home. And if you love animals, please help them. Do it locally. Support your local no-kill shelters, your local wild animal sanctuaries. Make a difference where you can.
On Animal Outtakes, every week, it's a new animal adventure.
From meeting curious lemurs to feeding big cats and hosing down rhinos, there's never a dull moment. And sometimes these amazing animals chime in. Tune in to Animal Outtakes to find out what they have to say.
Watch Animal Outtakes this weekend on ABC 7.
Attention, this is an important message for anyone who had an IVC filter placed to prevent blood clots from traveling to their heart or lungs. Did your IVC filter move, break, or cause organ damage? The FDA warns that IVC filters may cause serious complications, such as heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, even death. If you or a loved one suffered serious complications, call IVC Filter Helpline now. You may be entitled to compensation. IVC filters are designed to prevent blood clots. If your IVC filter moved or broke, and you suffered heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, or if a loved one died as a result, call IVC Filter Helpline today. Our network of experienced attorneys is ready to fight for you. You'll pay nothing unless there's a recovery in your favor. Call today for a free confidential consultation. Don't fight this alone. Call IVC Filter Helpline now.
Please call 800-897-6764. That is 800-897-6764.
Looks like we're getting another new neighbor.
Now you could be the millionaire next door. Play Monopoly Florida Edition scratch-off games with a top prize of $5 million. The Florida Lottery. Just imagine.
At Granny Nannies, we provide your loved ones with the care they deserve. Compassionate and experienced help right where you need it most. At home. Visit us at grannynannies.com.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
Well, here's the Danny Jr. of the family.
Hi, Judy.
Hi, it's so great to spend time with you and your family. And you're going to finish off with a little dessert.
Dessert, that's right. You know, after your big meal at Danny's, if you crave that extra something sweet, we have plenty of options for you. But two of our highlights are the cannolis and the tiramisu. And they're great. It's a great way to finish your meal. And what I love about it is that it's $3.99. So, you know, you don't have to spend $8 to $10 to get that dessert. You know, then it becomes a question. But that little something sweet is available at a good price, and it's a home run.
It's a total home run. Yeah. And besides your leftovers that you're going to have for sure, you might want to consider a dessert for the next day and another pizza. It's that good here at Danny's Pizzeria up in Brandon. Danny, I have to tell you, you and your family have been tremendous, and I look forward to many more visits.
Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure having you here.
Bueno appetito, everybody.
Well, thank you, Judy. And Entertainment News, America's Prince is getting a new documentary, I Am JFK Jr. It's a tribute to a good man. It's a documentary about JFK Jr., or John, as you know, from his early days toddling around the White House and saluting his dad during the funeral to his death in a plane crash. And the anniversary is tomorrow. That was back in 1999 on July 16th. The documentary hits select theaters July 22nd. Now, Mick Jagger may have to get his only satisfaction changing diapers. Make it baby number 8 for the Mixter. Representatives for the rock legend say his girlfriend Melanie Hamrick is pregnant. The 72-year-old frontman of the Rolling Stones has already 7 children and 2 grandchildren. The children range in age from 17 to 45. As I said, he's also a grandfather, but hey, good for him. He's still young at heart and still touring, which is maybe harder than being a father. At the box office this weekend, it's Pets versus Ghosts. The new Ghostbusters movie premieres today. It's predicted to make between $38 and $40 million for its opening, but analysts believe it could scare up more than that. If that's the case, it'll be a tight competition between that and The Secret Life of Pets, which is a phenomenal movie. It's expected to earn around $50 million in its second weekend, Pets is. And finally, a New Jersey comedian telling grown-ups to leave Pokemon Go to the kids. She's introducing a new spin on the game called Chardonnay-go. Players use their phones to hunt for glasses of wine hidden all over instead of this creepy digital creatures that she says are creepy. Anyway, the app doesn't really exist yet, but she says her idea is very promising and could open up many possibilities, and I know a lot of adults who actually would probably like to play Chardonnay Go.
I can imagine. You know, you especially can go, you hunt down grapes or magnums or, you know.
Exactly, especially on a Friday afternoon. All right, John, have a great day.